music is important, but that's not the only thing we want to do. So the whole the intention of these episodes that we're gonna do from now on is that we create a program where you feel like home. Shit went down when recently I was working in my previous company. Yes, I was not feeling good, and that was not physically. The thing that saved me was talking, was being vocal, was expressing, was knowing this is not a taboo, was knowing that it's fine, we all go through it. I can totally understand those people who don't want to talk about it because, yes, you feel ashamed about it.
Exactly. So the thing is that people don't come up and they don't want to talk because of the hesitation that they have. People just won't accept it.
Yeah.
What we have, you know, been told all along with our childhood is that you have to save it up. You don't need to open up to everybody. These are the things and this is the life. You'll go through ups and downs and everything. But then the point is, you have to acknowledge when your ups and downs are seriously hindering your work routine or your daily life.
Okay, so I have never spoken about this like in public as such, because see, I've always been a person that likes to listen to people, but I am not much of a sharer to be. That whenever I am going through something, I try to help at least 5 people a day, so that I just feel like if I can't help myself, I can help others. Whenever I open up, people are not surprised, they're in a way shocked. So basically, what do you think for a person like that, who just world refuses to understand, not because they don't want to understand, they're incapable of understanding their mental state. What do you think is the solution for people like that?
The mental well-being is not specific to a person. And it is very difficult for a normal person to, you know, come up and talk about the issues, the problems. It is 10 times difficult for a person who have that, impression on people that yes, he's a or she's a very happy-go-lucky kind of person, cheerful person. And then it is really hard for people to believe them. You have to believe in yourself that yes, there's something wrong with me. I'm not able to, you know, go through life the way I used to, or whatever it is, just go out and seek help.
Honestly, this is a bit difficult for me than Ishan or Shiv because
we're awesome.
Fuck off. What I want to talk about is how different people like experience the same thing in a different way. So if I experience some stuff, I might take it to my heart and take a lot of time to recover.
Yes, basically everybody has their own ways to, you know, cope up with their situations.
So I experienced it in a very different way than other people, and it took me a lot of time, which often makes me think that how and what, like, fuck.
A lot of people, like, the best advice they can give to somebody is like, okay, you're sad, just let it go. You're sad, just stop being sad. Or maybe this shouldn't matter so much to you. Tomorrow morning, wake up and don't be depressed. Like, that is not what they say, but this is what they imply. See, I honestly believe that it's not their fault. No, nobody can definitely understand the gravity of your thoughts. It's hard enough to express yourself in the first place. And then on top of that, we've got this ideology of being cool if you're not feeling anything, or if you're cold-hearted, or if you're, you know, emotionless. So in a place where everything is such a lie, what do you think this whole thing that we're trying to do right now, how is that going to help such people who honestly are convinced that literally nothing or nobody can help them?
Like, this is the layman thing. If a person goes out to a friend or family or whatever, other person is going to say this only, you know, just let it go, or it shouldn't affect you that much. But when you come and talk to people giving out help, and we know, alright, we have our ethics and rules and we have studied this, and this platform is giving them that. A person who wasn't able to acknowledge it before in his or her life, now if the person sees this and is like, okay, fine, it's anonymous. This initiative would let people have that confidence and believe that yes, I can go and, you know, get help for myself in the right ways.
The whole concept of mental health is taken very lightly. I want to be the one who really changes that. So I don't know how many people we can reach, but then this is the best that we can do. It's totally normal, happens with everyone, but the entire thing is about talking. I think that's where it starts and that's where it ends. And if you don't have anyone to talk about it, we are here for you.
Definitely.
And then we can provide you that platform.
In India, the counselors have been not that serious about it. They are taking out their dependency onto something else.
Yeah.
An external stimuli. And that shouldn't be happening.
That takes more time, I guess.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You have to have that person stand on their feet independent.
I don't know how I'm even like sitting here, but the point is maybe because over time I worked on it bit by bit. A year passed, now it's about to be 2 years. At least I can say that I can stand up in front of 200 people and I can perform. Yeah.
That's good. So you're anyhow making a progress. That is the important point. You have to make progress and you will make progress. It might not go in a day or a two, but yes, bit by bit, little steps at a time, it will definitely, you know, make progress on its way.
But now when I look back and I can see where I am, it's a big achievement for me. So all the people out there who can at least relate to me, even one person, I'm just gonna tell them, it's gonna happen.